Today what I have here is a Digitech Whammy effects pedal. Now, I was introduced to this pedal when we had the phenomenal Casey Benjamin, he's a Grammy Award winning artist, come as our artist in residence for our pay series. And he came and he had a bunch of other gadgets and widgets, and he had this one. And when I saw it, I was like, what is this red little box? I don't know if some of you guys can see it. But it's this little red little square box. And I'm like, what is it doing? And so I finally had the opportunity to hear him play it, and I was wowed and amazed by what all the different sounds it could produce. At the time, I didn't know that the saxophone could do such things. And so as I saw that, and I'm like, man, I gotta get one of those. So I decided to get one, clearly. And so I did my research and I studied, and I found out that the effects pedals were originally first came on the scene in about the 1930s. And earlier when they first came on, these were more likely used for guitars, for more an acoustic instrument, sometimes bass player, not as much. But over the years, it has evolved. Now, originally, what these sounds go after now, such as distortion or loops or whammy, or as you heard in the moment, those were considered bad sounds or something that you didn't want to be present in your playing. And so musicians earlier, they wanted to get rid of these sounds, but later on, musicians were like, oh, this sounds kind of cool. It's not as the plain, it's not pure. So at first, this was viewed as something as a dirty sound or something that was negative. And through time has evolved, and people that got attracted to the sound. And so, you know, monophonic instruments such as a saxophone, we had got jealous, and we were like, well, we don't get to make all those sounds. We don't get to, you know, do all the crazy stuff. And so we found different clever ways that you can incorporate the multi-sounds that the guitarists can make and the bass players can make through different things. So this particular pedal can do many different things, but one of my favorite ones is the octave effects pedal. So essentially what it does is it takes what I'm saying now, so I can use it as a vocalist or as an instrumentalist. So I can take what I'm saying
and drop it down to another octave.
So I can do all kind of crazy cool things with this. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna first let you hear what it sounds like as dry saxophone. So that means like with no effects, no kind of distortion or anything like that. Then I wanna let you see how I can use this in a more modern setting, okay?
So this is clean saxophone.
Thank you. Thank you.